yesterday, Scott, was talking about how God prunes us and he cuts some things away. And there's some things that God protects us from. He cuts away. He talked about how he went home back into the Bay Area and he saw this young lady. And this young lady had teeth all messed up and looked like life had really beaten her up pretty bad. And she goes up and said, "Do you remember me?" And he's like, "I don't remember. You don't remember me? I don't remember you. My name is so and so. You sure you don't remember me?" He said, "I don't remember you." And he said he left and went to call one of his friends and said, "Man, do you know, remember so and so?" He goes, "Oh yeah, man, she used to like you. You used to have the biggest crush on her. She was so fine back in the day." He said, "I thank God." Now, Dad, don't come calling me and texting and sending me emails. All our children are beautiful. Amen. But he said he was thankful that he didn't get what he wanted so quickly. Amen.
Amen.
Oh, now y'all, I'm having a ball with you. Y'all say, "Oh, now I get it." Yeah. Me first, get it now, and we avoid the blessing. Can I just talk about that for a quick moment? A happy man is a man that rejects the philosophy of the world. The me first, to get it now, and those who want to avoid the unpleasant. The unpleasant. There's some things that are hard to do that are of God that needs to be done. And I talked about even this morning, I never get any joy out of disciplining my children. Never. Two reasons. One, I'm always disappointed of what they have done to make me want to discipline them.
Amen.
But secondly, if I don't discipline them, then I create children. I create an environment that no one can deal with.
Amen.
Come on, somebody. If I truly love them, I don't try to kill them, but you have to punish them. And I know the young folks up there. You know, Pastor, we thought you was cool. I'm just trying to say.
Preach, preacher.
A life without correction, accountability, and discipline is a life that is impossible to deal with. And then you're raised that way, undisciplined, and then you come into the church with a leadership role and you bring that same attitude to that leadership role. Me first, get it now, and avoid the unpleasant. Amen. The unpleasant things of praying for those who despise you, the unpleasant things of forgiving those who have dogged you out. Come on, somebody. A godly man rejects that philosophy. A godly woman rejects that philosophy. A happy person rejects that philosophy. Second, he says, stands not in the way of sinners. Watch this. To stand not in the way of sinners. The word sinner, underline the word sinner. Those who take notes or are you writing your Bible? Sinner. The word sinner is interesting. This word sinner means to be a disturbance, to cause trouble, to create chaos, to preach the peace. You didn't get it. He says a happy man, a happy woman is one who does not go around making trouble, doesn't go around causing disturbance, doesn't go around stirring up mess. Are you all with me? He does not make trouble, but he is obedient to God's word. He doesn't hang with people who cause trouble. You still didn't get it. Some of us, I'm gonna tell you, there's some folks who was, someone told me about someone that doing prison ministry, just recently doing prison ministry, ran into a high school friend, and that high school friend is serving 25 years in prison for something that he did not do, but he was hanging with a group of troublemakers. Come on, somebody, and it happens at work. You want to hang with those who you think are moving someplace and going somewhere, and all they're doing is causing trouble. You do it in a church, hang with them. He said, godly people who are blessed, people who are happy, they don't stir up mess, and they don't cause trouble. Amen. Don't stand in the way of sinners. Are you all with me?
Amen.
They ask questions like, how is this helpful? What can we do a blessing versus how do we stir up mess. Y'all with me on that?
Amen.
He says, sit with the scornful. Those who are scornful, they blame everyone for everything. It's never their fault. It's always something else, someone else's fault. They never take responsibility for addressing their own issue.
Amen.
Amen. The scornful, they are overly critical. Come on, somebody.
Come on.
And they never self-reflect.
Come on.
But listen, he says, but those who are happy, those who are godly, those who are blessed, he said they have the opposite attitude. They are selfless in their actions and in their motivations. I had a young lady tell me just recently, it was pretty sad. She was talking about this problem in her house, and she was talking about all the things that she should get credit for. And she was having this whole record of what everybody has done wrong and why and all that she has done right. And I said, what about your actions and your motivation? Is your motivation to get credit for what you do? Or is your motivation to do what you do? Come on, somebody. The letter we heard today, the letter that was read to us, it was no evil motivation. Pastor McReynolds just did what he did because that's what he did. Come on, somebody.
Amen.
If you got to keep a record of all the things you've done for folks. Amen.
Amen.
And obedience, so it's selflessness and obedience. Obedience to the will of God and to the law of God. And the third thing, so it's selflessness, it's obedience, but it's also cheerfulness. Not critical, a great complainer, but he or she accepts all that comes from the hand of God, not bitter, because he or she believes that God will work it out. Do you get it? So those who are godly, those who are happy, they recognize that some bad stuff may happen to you, but it doesn't matter because God will work it out. They know the book of Psalms is a story of what people have gone through and how they got through it. It teaches us how to get through it as well. Does that make sense? And that no matter what comes our way, if God be for us, who can be against us? We can smile even when we're in trouble. We can have joy even when we're in trouble because we know that God is the ultimate worker out of it. Oh, man. And that we can have joy even in the darkest hour. There was a newly ordained deacon by the name of Stephen. And I can imagine that he was all excited that he was the first deacon in all the Bible. Amen. And shortly after his ordination celebration, he was sharing the word of God and he was being stoned to death.
Amen.
I remember